Hi, I'm Mike Sprayberry of the Hoshizaki Tech Support, and welcome to this edition of Hoshizaki Technical Training. In today's video, we'll be looking at KM control boards, their history, specifications on the different boards, as well as the 15-20 minute control board check. Let's go ahead and get started. First, let's go over the history and specification of the boards. The KM unit started with the A board and B boards. These were used in the early 1980s. You will notice on this type of board, there was a transformer that supplied the control voltage to the board. Power to this unit was supplied by the K1 connector on the board that had a 9-pin connector. We then started transitioning over to the C board in the late 1980s. This board was the first board in the KM series to have an external transformer to provide control voltage for the board. With that change, the K2 connector now supplies low voltage power to the KM control board and the K1 connector supplies voltage to the relays. This is also the first board with a 10-pin connector. With the introduction of the C board, we also added a series modification numbers starting with the B model. In the early 1990s, we added the Alpine board to our lineup. This board added a high temperature and low water safety to the board. Though the board is similar, it is not interchangeable with the C board. The board can be found on some B models and was used all the way into some of our F models. In November of 1998, we replaced all C and Alpine boards with the E board, which is green in color. This board has two versions, the 2A1410-01 and 02. The 02 has a switch selector switching between number 1 and number 4 relays, allowing it to be a replacement for either the Alpine or C board. This board is also the first board that had LEDs to indicate which relays are operating components. This board added audible alarms for safety and not only replaced the C board and Alpine board, but was also found on many F and H models. In January of 2009, we started using the G board. The G board is yellow and allowed us to utilize a mechanical bend control that plugged into the K4 connector. It also added S5 dip switch for advanced features. This board was used on a variety of H model, and it was also used on the KMS 1401 MLJs. In August of 2017, we started using the J board. This board was blue in color and was used on a variety of J models until 2024. This board had a freeze time control. In May of 2018, units were produced with the K board. The K board added a cleaning mode. By flipping the toggle switch on the unit into the clean mode, it goes into the cleaning sequence. For following the proper cleaning instructions, we recommend you look at the maintenance label. On the maintenance label, you will find the sequence of the cleaning operation. This board will give you a beep, giving you signals at certain points in the cycle. Some models using the K board had an ultrasonic bend control. The bend control had a driver board that had a jumper wire that plugged into the K4 connector on the K board. In September 2021, as more units were using the ultrasonic bend control, we switched to the K+ board. This board integrated the ultrasonic bend control driver board into the control board. This board is currently the only other replacement board for another board since the E board. The K+ board also added an automated cleaning mode and is still being put in our current production on KM models. The later iteration of the K+ board, the 2A9678-02, added freeze-up detection. The K and K+ board have been used in a variety of J model units. Now let's talk about the H board used in a variety of units from 2009 to 2023. This small green board from Japan was used in a variety of H and J models. We stopped using the H board in 2023 and started using the H+ board. This change was implemented to have the board produced in the States like our other boards. The H+ board is a red board that looks identical to the K board. However, its sequence mirrors the image of the original H board. These boards are not interchangeable, so make sure you look at the board's part number before switching out the board. The H plus board is not interchangeable with the original H board, and the H plus board has been used in a variety of JMOP. Now remember, unless it's the E board with the C board and Alpine board, or the K plus board with the K board, you must replace the control board of the same type of board that was originally in the unit. For example, do not replace a J board with a K board, or a J board with a G board. Even though the boards have similar layout with their pins, they have different functions. It will not work in the other units. Pay attention to your board part numbers when buying a replacement board. Refer to the unit's part manual for other boards and for the correct part number. Now let's review some common features between the control boards, excluding the A and B boards, and the original H board due to their different layouts. Since the C board, the K2 connector supplies low voltage to the control board from the transformer. Then you have the K1 connector, has 110 volts coming into the board that goes to the different relays. Next, we have the K3 connector where you plug the thermistor in. The black K5 connector is used to plug in the float switch. From the E board, we have an alarm reset button. This will reset all the alarms except for the 6 and 7 beep alarms. Those are voltage alarms and will stop when the voltage is corrected. With the E board, we also had an output test button. This button, when pressed, would sequence all of the relays on the board along with their LEDs, as well as the components that particular relay controlled. This gives you the ability to make sure that the board is actually sequencing the components they're controlling. Starting with the G board, the K4 connector is used to plug in the mechanical bin control. Unless you used a unit that had a thermostatic bin control, if that's the case, the K4 connector will be jumped. If you have a K+ board, the K4 connector is not used, because using the K+ board, it uses an ultrasonic bin control and it plugs into a separate board connector. Also, you'll notice there are LEDs on the boards. These let you know which component is being sequenced at that time. The LEDs that are on the board include the power OK light, the hot gas valve, the pump motor, the water inlet valve, and the compressor. If you want to know about other LEDs, we recommend you go to our website, www.hoshizakiamerica.com/support/manuals. Look at the service manual for that particular unit, and in that manual, it'll give you a full control board layout as far as the function of each LED. As stated earlier, the K board has a cleaning sequence on it, and there's a connector on the K board, the K9 connector, that connects to the switch. When the switch is placed into the clean mode, the switch diverts the power to the clean circuit on the board and starts the cleaning mode. Make a note, once the cleaning mode is started, it cannot be stopped. On another note, the wiring for the 10-pin connector has changed several times since its introduction with the C board, so always check the pin layout and the wiring diagram when changing or checking the connector. Now, before replacing a board or deeming a board bad, make sure you check the dip switch settings and make sure they are set correctly as corresponds with the unit by looking at the service manual. There's a 15 to 20 minute checkout that you can do on the control board to make sure they're operating properly. On the G board, if you'll take the S4 dip switches, turn 5 and 6 to off. On the J or K board, if you'll take the S4 dip switches and turn 5 on, then turn the unit back on, and then after 5 minutes in the freeze cycle, you want to drain the water and allow the float switch to open, and the unit will go into harvest for 10 to 15 seconds. On the J and K board, let the unit go past the 5 minutes of freeze and wait for the pump to shut off for 10 seconds. That's verifying your anti-slush. Then drain the water in the tank and allow the float switch to open. And again, after 15 to 20 seconds, the float switch will open and the unit will go into harvest for 10 to 15 seconds. Then allow the unit to go back into freeze for 5 more minutes. Then pull the wire off the K5 connector, which will be your float switch. After 10 to 15 seconds, the unit should go into a pump out cycle. And that just confirms that the board is working correctly and sequencing properly. Thank you for joining us today. If you have any questions about KM control boards or any other technical issues, feel free to contact us at Hoshizaki Tech Support.
Thank you for watching this video. For more videos like this, feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel. We also offer a virtual and in-person training course on Hoshizaki products for technicians. If you're interested in this, go to hoshizakiamerica.com/support/training or scan the QR code on the screen. For any further assistance, you can contact us by phone or at email. The contact details are on the right side of the screen. Again, thanks for watching.